Good morning, guys. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I'm blessed and very grateful that you guys are checking in to actually get an update today on the cotton sub. So, as I told you guys already, I'm learning this stuff with you guys as you learning it. I'm testing it out. You seeing the results in real time as they going on. I ain't had nothing. I ain't bull crapping around or nothing like that. So, speaking with my supplier this morning and find out that it's not an actual A3. It's more closer to a 11 by 17. It's actually, I believe it's like, I want to say 10.75 by probably 15 and a half. So that's more inclined with the 11 by 17, which may actually work out a little better because the other one was wider than an 11. So you would definitely need 13 by 19 paper, which is something that, I mean, it may not be hard to get, but it's definitely not going to be as easy as it's going to be to find 11 by 17 paper. So we're not going to let it stop us. It ain't going to be no obstacle or nothing like that. You guys see how the shirt's looking. Actually, the ones that you saw, those were the ones that I'm using. You can still break them down in half. If it's 15 and a half, you're going to get like 7.25 if you chop it down in half and you still got almost 11 inches. So you good to go. Ain't nobody gonna complain about no artwork on the shirt. You putting that on a small shirt or a kid's shirt, it's gonna look outrageous. If you use the big one, you're gonna be even more gravy. You're gonna make more money if you chop it down half. If you don't chop it down half, you just rock with it how it is. You're still gonna make money. Either which way, it's a beautiful thing. It's giving all of us the opportunity to sublimate on black shirts, purple shirts, navy blue shirts, red shirts. You already saw the red and the black. You saw the white. Any kind of cotton, guys, we good to go. We gonna rock and roll with it. We gonna see what it is. I mean, I'm already made the commitment to grab like thousands of sheets of it. So if you guys rocking and rolling with me, it shouldn't run out anytime soon. If the demand is high, I mean, it may be going real fast. I don't really know. It don't really matter. But I've also made the decision to actually stop using transfer paper, and I don't know if that's something I'm going to regret or what it is, but guess what? I'm trying out something new, man. This is what I do. I don't like doing the same things over and over and over. I told you guys in past videos, I don't like doing things over and over and over. So I like trying new stuff. And if this wind up being like a home run out the gate or maybe even a grand slam, because I already got things on base. I got silk screen on base, the transfers. I'll put that in the same, you know, category. I got sublimation, I got heat transfer vinyl. I mean, now we also have sublimation that we putting on cotton because people come in all the time. I don't want a white shirt, I want on a black shirt. And they want to bring their own shirts and stuff like that. So, I mean, hey, you can bring your own shirt, not a problem. Let me get this shirt. As long as it's cotton, we good to go. Oh, yes. Bringing it all the way back and taking it all the way forward. That last video I did with the cotton sub, the reason why that cotton sub did not stick well on that red shirt was because it actually was a polyester shirt. Mom wasn't mad. I told her, like, you should have told me it was a polyester shirt because I probably wouldn't have even did it. But we learning at the same time. So you saw that video. I'm probably going to put a link on this video so that you can go back and watch that video and see. I actually put the material on top of another polyester shirt. Now, in the initial peel up, it was acting kind of crazy. But after it chilled for probably like another 2-3 seconds, it was no problem. It peeled right on up, not an issue. I went on ahead and hit it again. The white was kind of bleeding, but not really. I'm going to put a picture like somewhere on here, boop, somewhere, so that you guys can see the actual shirt. But I didn't like how the white looked on the red shirt, and I was, you know, I've had issues with some materials not being labeled correctly. They say that they were what they were and wasn't, and this, I thought this was a situation like that, but it actually wound up, I looked at it afterward because it felt just like cotton. I didn't even think to look in it because I touched it and it felt just like cotton, and it had heat transfer vinyl on it already, and it had silkscreen on it, so I just automatically assumed it was cotton, but that's what you get for assuming. Always look at the tags and make sure, but it really don't matter. It worked on polyester too, as you saw, I mean, but your white's not going to pop as hard if you're putting it on top of a polyester shirt that has color in it, so... But there's really no need to put it on polyester. It's the whole point in which I'm saying. This material is formulated strictly for cotton. And I'm talking about you can put it on jeans, jean jackets. You can put it on canvas hats. You can put it on hats. You can put it on shoes. Anything that's cotton, you good to go. White, dark colors. So that is what it is, guys. I just want to be 100% transparent. With all that said, out the way, done. And acknowledge, we moving on. I'm gonna touch back with you guys when I got some more of those shirts to do. Actually, I'm doing three of them today on white shirts, and I'm actually gonna put the artwork inside of the shirt. So we'll see how it look, because the last one I did had ghosting, and as I told you guys before, for anybody that didn't see these videos before, you wanna learn how do you sublimate on cotton with this material. If you're sublimating on a color shirt, with the material, you have to make your artwork a little bit bigger than the actual material so that you can have like a bleed on the outside. You can then take heat transfer vinyl if you want to and layer that, or you can just let it be, because after a couple washes, in my understanding, it's gonna go away. Now, I put it on the black shirt, didn't see any issues after washing. I mean, I didn't even see the stuff that bled over at all. I mean, so I don't really know. We have to try it out on like a lighter color shirt, but black shirts, you wash it, have a little bit of ghost, and it's going to be out of there after the first wash. White shirt, you want to definitely keep your artwork inside of the material so that you don't have any issues with ghosting. That's about it, guys. I appreciate you checking in as always. Definitely, I need you guys to do me a favor and do yourself a favor. Subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell so that you can get notifications when we drop in new videos. Check us out on social media. I haven't really been too active on Instagram, I'm going to be honest with you. I kind of, with all the changes they doing, I kind of got turned off with it. I have to find a motivation to get back in. But I think that's going to be coming up soon, because I got some things that I want to do. But check us out on social media as well. If you want to get some of the dope apparel that we make, you can definitely check us out at techbycustoms.com. And we're going to be hitting you guys upside the head with more videos, more content, more new things that we're trying out, and actually things that we bring to the table. So just stay tuned with us, guys. Stay in tune with us. Rock and roll with us. We're going to get some money together. We're going to make our customers happy. And we're going to see some growth. So it is what it is. You guys know what I do at the end. Always make sure that you love and respect one another, okay? Peace.